So what is the Sergeant Major's role in implementing the Commandant's Plan and Guidance?
So the Sergeant Major of the Marine Corps' role in implementing the Commandant's Plan and Guidance is pretty broad, to be frank. As soon as General Berger came on deck, he gave a brief to myself, Sergeant Major Green, as he was outgoing, and the senior enlisted leadership of the Marine Corps, and actually tasked us, go after a couple of things. Mainly focus on how can we better develop Marines, train Marines, lead Marines. So that's what we've been focused on over the course, like the first 6 months of being here.
And how do these February seminars play into that?
So specifically, we spend a lot of time when we talk about developing a force, talking about things, capabilities, right? We're going to be able to fight in a certain way. We're going to fight with this sort of equipment. What we don't always do is invest a lot of time in developing the Marines. They're going to fly those planes, shoot those weapons, drive that, or what are the capabilities going to be? So with that in mind, we looked at putting together three different focus areas that are specifically looking at how to better develop Marines. One, recruiting to retention, talent management, talent development. Basically looking at recruiters find the very best citizens that we have that join the United States Marine Corps. They do a fabulous job. There's no hidden pool that we're not tapping into that are not coming in the Marine Corps. What we do with them after that, how do we develop that talent? Recruiter found talent, goes to recruit training, goes to an MOS school, and then what? We manage those Marines through performance evaluation. We manage them through assignments. We manage them through further training. We manage them through retention. Mm-hmm. We manage how we take care of Marines, but how we develop them is a whole different discussion.
So if you can, you know, summarize this real quick, it's pretty much we're recruiting what we're going to recruit. How do we make sure they stay out throughout their career and fill all the spaces that the Marine Corps requires?
Right. And so talk about development for a moment. One of the other groups is enlisted professional personal development. Mm-hmm. I'd break that down into three categories. Enlisted professional mm-hmm. military education, what you and I remember as the Lance Corporal Seminar, Corporal's Course, you know, all the way up to our advanced school for gunnery sergeants. Mm-hmm. That is common PME, professional military education, that every single Marine has to have that's enlisted. Mm-hmm. What is its curriculum supposed to look like? Things that are common to me and you as Marines, right? Now, professional development, you grew up as an artilleryman. I grew up as an infantryman. We're not going to go to the same school to make us better at our MOS. That's professional development and other schools that we're going to go to that enhance our capabilities, warfighting capabilities, MOS responsibilities. Mm-hmm. And there's that last leg, which is personal development. Think college. Think advanced certifications. Think vocational trades. These are another leg of our educational and enlisted development that we're looking at right now.